Well, hello everyone and welcome back. Got all the whole window holes in. Did all the holes up in here and there. Got that photo etch piece in that has window holes. Got some holes up in there. On both sides. Of course, on that side as well. I did some marker lights there and there. There's these little cylinder towers right there. I also did a marker light up on top here. Got all those holes drilled in for those lights, and here, even down in here, all those are done. Got the fiber optics into the bridge. The bridge I actually had to pop off, and that way I could re-drill holes. It's supposed to have holes in here, and I could not find them. Whether the drill bit was hot, and when it backed out, all the burrs were warm and then they cooled and closed the holes up, or debris got, I don't know. I could not find the holes and get them through, so I have a nice little set of drill bits that I got at Wonderfest last year, which I am probably going to pick up another one or two sets of these. They work pretty good. Here's one trying to sneak out. I was able to get a real tiny one and drill in and put these little fiber optics in. And I did two red ones kind of to simulate when they're like in red alert. I think it would probably be a lot more of these windows would be red during that red alert, but I didn't want them all red. That's the top. Everything's hit with a black coat. I got the LED strips here in the front. I got two, just 3mm LEDs here because I really didn't need a strip here just to shine down on these two. I drilled two holes there for a marker lights. And what else we got going on? We got a lot going on the bottom. I drilled some of the holes out in there for some lights. I drilled two and two there. I drilled a marker light there, and I drilled a single one in the trench, kind of at an angle, and maybe to give a little bit of a glow up front. I'm not sure if it will or not. Drilled the holes for these spotlights way down in there that'll shine this way, and same with another one here that'll shine this way, and I'll have those on a switch. That way I don't have to have them on because they're not Canon, but I would like to get a little bit of light shining down under here. So when you look under, you can see. So I'll put that on a switch, and then that's what these are here. They're little lighthouse LEDs. I just brought the negatives over the metal, and actually just took the metal from the LED and soldered the two negatives together, and then ran a black wire down to the negative on this circuit. Then I put two resistors on each of the positives, brung them together and twisted them, and tied and soldered a white wire to kind of let me know that that's a separate circuit, and that came to the one that's in the back. Took its negative and just bent it around and soldered it to that strip up top here. What I got going on here is I just took some old sprues. Here was one that was an actual eye shape. It was actually an eye shape and even had little posts going down to give it a little raise. So I glued that down and then glued two pieces of sprue about yay long to the sides of it to give it the width I needed for the strip LED to go down, to stick down to. And kind of here, I just put a sprue across the opening here and laid three of them down this way to get this one to stick to something. Fairly simple. And then the main wire coming from the base can come up and attach there, positive and negative, and then attach to this. And then the other switch can go to that positive. So we're going to keep. So I looped the positive and negative from this strip to this strip down. And now having the negatives for these spots already completed. That circuit's completed. What we're going to do here is we're going to keep continuous and connecting these two, and then connecting, I think I'm going to just wire red right off to here, and wire black right off to here. I don't know if I'm going to go do a, like a circle, or I can go boom, boom, boom. Oh, that's right, I am going to wire these off. Bring a red and a red, because one of these will tie off to these marker lights, and then the other one will just switch over to the engines. We'll loop through the engine. Actually, that'll be that way. We'll loop up to the engines, and these can loop together. I think I'm going to do 1 5-millimeter in each of the big ones, kind of right in center. So the bulb's hidden behind that centerpiece, and then everything else is, and then that way I have one flickering style instead of having four different flickering styles. I mean, I could, that would kind of look cool with them flickering a little different in each one of these. I also think I'm going to have to, because I'm going to blast, but I think a 5 millimeter, just one back there, will work fine. I was thinking if I could, I don't want to be able to see the bulb as much. So if I put it dead center here, and then actually put, I think I'm going to put a little putty, because right here, this is all open in there, all the way up through. It's almost like this is a half, this is a half, this is a half, and this is a half. But I'm just going to build a light box right around this whole thing, and I'm just going to stick a little perfect plastic putty in this area here, just to keep from light going into this cavity here and light leaking out that way. I could even put a little bit here, but this mostly will be covered up with the light box. But then we can leap between Easter, and I got a little 3 millimeter red one that we can put a single. I think we'll just put one single red one there. Cut the dome off the bulb so it really spreads. And I think I'll do the same with those. So yeah, I think we will wire this red. One red to here and one red to there, and use these two end ones to jump to that and then to one of these. But that's what we're going to do. We're going to continue jumping over here, jumping into these two, and then the lights up on the top part will leap up. You know, like I said, one will go here, one will go to the engines, one will pull something off of here and do a loop here. And we also got to catch the LED SMD for there. That's where we're at, so we just need to keep trucking here. And we'll continue with this negative side. But that's kind of why I lay my strips where I know the positives on one side and negatives on the other, instead of having to crisscross, you know. So I try to keep my positives so I can just go right in a row. Now these are going to be two separates, which is using a little more wire, but not really, because now we're not looping across there as well. And I pre-went and did all the resistors on everything, too. Off camera. I need to bore you guys with all that. I used old resistors I cut off. What was that for? I think for the 350 Enterprise. Original TOS. I didn't need the resistors on certain LEDs. So we got the negatives looped, at least on the bottom part of the ship. Don't like when the solder joints look foggy. That's a cold solder joint. There we go. We just gotta do the two off of here. This one's going fairly quick as far as the wiring. There we go. So those are, everything is looped together on the bottom. We gotta do this, or this, yeah, the bottom. And we gotta do the same to the top. What we'll do here is we'll mark this one right about there. See if we can splice the wire. I can bend you to the wire. I need you. Like that. And then we can make a tail. And that should work right there. That's more than long enough. Now allow me to slide some more of this insulation, I think. There we go. Yep. You can move this one in. Then I can just take this and get this one out of the way. Use you to hold. There we go, we got a good wrap around it. And then that can go right up to the one of these, which will probably, it'll be this one. So that negative, and we're good. Noticing, you notice that as I did the negative on the inside, did the negative on this inside, so it just loops, and then this one can loop out and around. It just kind of makes your soldering a little neater if you can do that. If you know you're going to loop across, that having it have to go all the way up, and then I guess it's just a little neater. I think this is the end of the loop. Yeah, because then this is going to loop to the SMD. I always cut my wires just a hair big in case strippers decide to cut the wire, because that's been known to happen. Especially if your dial here that sets the torque on how hard it grabs the wire to pull the insulation. I think it also sets on how much it pinches, and if you have it set too tight, it'll pinch so hard it'll cut right through the wire, especially on that small gauge wire like that. We'll straight up just strip this and make it a tail. Go. We'll attach that to the top of the ship. I need a little bit of red for that, so we have a tail there. And these are braided wires, so I gotta kind of give them a twist. And we'll put a little piece of shrink tube over you. Okay, press strip these, and then we're ready to do a light test, I think. I just gotta get this, you gotta run a wire, do I have like one of those double, I always keep a pair that's like this, for testing until I actually send the wire down through the ship, because I can just stick this up. You immediately want to go right to that right there. For a temporary attachment. And do we make you go here for now? Just for a temp?
Yeah.
That's what we do. It's a temporary. So we have our spots on too, to make sure they're working. Alright, that should be everything. We just gotta bring. Alright, those are connected. Everything's connected here, except for. Oh, let's get our. Let's quickly get that SMD in. Before we call this a night. This can junk the wire, can just float around, it's so tiny. But you, we're going to want to glue to a piece of styrene. Super glue there. I mean, for now, we'll just tape that just to see what it is doing. So what we're going to do here is just temporarily hook you to there. And see, that gives us a pretty nice reach there. Now you guys might be a little bit different. There we go. See, coffee is good. What we'll do here. Not to be any fancy, this is just a test.
This is just a test.
That's probably about how we're gonna have to hook this whole thing up. when it comes to gluing it together. That gets us through, so we should be able to go and close this. Are we gonna see lights? Of course you're gonna fucking touch. Hey! The spots are working good and they're not overly bright, which I was hoping they wouldn't be. There's a warp to this ship. It's actually got to get pressed like that. There, see, and then it snaps down. But that works good, those spots. From behind, it'll be like, whoa! But very nice. Yeah, and see that? That going, this is all going to get hit with black paint again from the outside. Yeah, I like that. Well, that having a white light there going through those yellow fiber optics, it's giving me the same kind of deal as those. And in these, since it's warm white, I'm going to run all clear fiber optics for those. But we're getting good, bright colors out of the light. The fiber optics, which makes me happy. Oh yeah, and with those things shining underneath, I am going to be, I think, very happy with that. Let's see what the underneath looks like. Yeah, and even all those, now that could be a little brighter there, those two, but like I said, once I stick fiber optics up, it'll catch the light better too. These are all just what makes it down in the hole. Mm-hmm. I like. Yeah, not bad at all. Well, there she is. Very, very, very long video. But I don't have my glasses on there. I can't see. Yeah. But I wanted to show you that. We got the lighting in. The only lighting left is the engine. And everything in the pylon, too. And then I think the wiring is going to come down into this from this pylon strut. And we'll drill a hole, because that way I can measure off of the key-in hole and measure over and then and write down. Plus, you got plenty of room to with the wire, so it really doesn't matter. But they're fitting much better that I, now that I say that, now that I got rid of that, so that fits a little tighter. Like I said, this ship's got a warp to it. Like when it comes to gluing, I'm actually going to have to push this top up a little bit to get the bottom to align with it. But yeah, then we can get working on these. And we got the photo etch to do in the rear half here. Got to paint and do the lighting and, and then I'm going to drill the holes for those things, a little bit of red through. I think it just gives a little something. But if I think I just do a little, I'm not going to have a bright red light come out of it, just a little red glow because the interior here they're asking for, where these are the inside of the launch bay tubes, are asking for a little red in there. So I think it'll be cool. But that's it. We're wired up. I appreciate you taking the time to watch. And until next time, see you soon.